So you're sitting there in music class and there's a quiz on identifying keys, or maybe you're learning a new piece and wonder which scale it's using so you can prepare for it easier, or maybe you just like to be a know-it-all like me. Whichever the case, being able to identify keys, and by extension scales and modes, is massively useful in any of these situations. Let's learn the C major, A minor keys and modes before we get into all the cheap mnemonics. Here it is. No sharps or flats. It's the only one you have to memorize on its own. First, let's check out the C major scale. It goes from C to B, 7 notes. That's why it's called a diatonic scale. If you already speak Greek, then it's much easier. Each of these notes is what's called a scale degree. C is 1, D is 2, E is 3, F is 4, G is 5, A is 6, and B is 7. These are not to be confused with intervals, as intervals are relative to the other notes, whereas these scale degrees are pretty much fixed. For example, if you travel downward from C, B is still the 7th scale degree, and this is something to remember because it is important for later. By the way, if you're interested in intervals, the scale is made up of this sequence of whole and half steps. Whole, whole, half, whole, 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 half. To find the relative minor scale in a major scale, we just need to find the 6th scale degree and then run a diatonic scale from there. In this case, we count from scale degree 1, which is C, and find scale degree 6 is an A. So now here's our minor scale. In this case, natural minor. We'll learn about the other minor scales at a later date. For now, we are going to call A the first scale degree, and it goes up from there. And that's all there is to it. So how can we tell if it's C major or its relative minor A minor? This can be blurry at times, but for now, what chord does the piece start with and what does it end with? Like, does it start and end on C major? Then it's C major. And if it starts and ends on A minor, try A minor. Now that we have the tonal theory of these keys down for these particular keys, let's find out the modes that are related to them and how to find them in every other key. The first mode is the easiest to find. We just take a look at the key signature and in this case notice that the song could be in C major. Okay, so that's the first mode, Ionian. Yeah, it just corresponds to the major key of tonal music theory. Super easy. Now we just follow up the major scale using all the same notes, but starting with whatever note is next. Here are the rest of the examples. Next is the second mode, Dorian. In this case, we start on D. Dorian is like a natural minor scale, but because of our key signature, the 6th scale degree ends up being raised. So like in a normal D minor scale, that would be a B flat, but in this case, it's a B natural. This mode is often used in medieval and Renaissance music, and strangely enough, minor jazz music as well. Not to mention its regular use in movie scores. The next mode is the third, Phrygian. This is like a minor scale but with a lowered second. It's often described as exotic, I suppose. It's fun and unstable. Fourth mode is Lydian. Lydian is like a major mode but with a raised fourth. I kind of get an open celestial vibe from using it. As silly as that sounds. The fifth mode is Mixolydian. I know, why do the names gotta be like this? Just try not to mix them up. This one is like a major key but with a lowered seventh. This mode is used so often it's crazy. Rock music uses it a ton. You could listen to almost any Soundgarden song and hear it. Medieval and Renaissance music use it in place of other major modes. And blues and jazz. This one and Dorian are used the most after normal major and minor. Speaking of minor, the next mode is number 6, Aeolian. Not only are you allowed to write that cool AE thing, but it's also an easy mode to learn. Do we know anything else based on scale degree 6? Well, if you can remember back a couple minutes ago when I talked about scales, I mentioned that a minor scale was based on scale degree 6 of the C major scale. Well, here we are again, and I think that's about it. Aeolian is massively popular, obviously. Last and least is mode 7, Locrian. Poor Locrian. Only progressive musicians, metalheads, and weirdo composers like me use you. And unfortunately, for good reason. There's no stability in it. Writing a piece in Locrian is like building a sandcastle with a golden retriever. It's very challenging. Here's why. Take that cool, unstable Phrygian mode, and now lower the fifth. Now our tonic chord is a diminished chord. How am I supposed to feel satisfied if a piece ends on this? All right, that's enough about modes. Let's go ahead and get into key signatures. You know how you've been working on your autograph for when you become a famous scrimshar? Well, keys have their own signature too. Let's learn how to read them. Let's start with the sharps because I'm a string player and sharps are way easier for me in nearly every respect. In tonal music, we add sharps in this order: F, C, G, D, A, E, B. Let's add a mnemonic to that. Fat cats go down alleys eating birds. Poor birds. Oh well, it's a circle of life. Blame Mufasa. Or if you're meta, blame Tim Rice. So here's the trick to finding major keys if you have sharps in your key signature. What we are doing is adding a leading tone with each sharp. Remember scale degree 7? That's what we are making when we write these sharps in the key signature. So in order to find scale degree 1, we just look a half step above the last sharp we added. That's all there is to it. So that first sharp we added, F sharp, that's just the leading tone for G major. So what about minor keys, I hear you scream into the eternal void? Well, the minor scale is built on scale degree 6, and if the last added sharp is scale degree 7, then that must mean... Yes, we drop down a whole step below the last added sharp. For the G major key signature, that would mean E minor. Okay, all you pianists, hymnal composers, and wind players, it's flat time. In tonal theory, we add flats in this order: B, E, A, D, G, C, F. Nice thing is the first four letters spell the word bead. I think this helps anyway. I tend to remember it as bead, go catch fish. I know it feels silly, but it does help. Also, fun fact that may or may not hurt your brain, but the sharps and flats orders are palindromatic when put together. Weird, right? What we're doing with flats is not as simple as adding a leading tone. In this case, we are lowering the fourth scale degree of the following key. Yeah, I'll get to an easy mnemonic in a sec, but for now, let's learn F major. One flat, that's B flat. It's the fourth of F. Yay. Because it's the fourth, if we walk up two whole steps to D, now we're on the sixth scale degree for our minor key. The flat minor keys all work like this. The major keys, on the other hand, are much more simple to decipher after that first flat. If we get to the next flat, E flat, now we just look at the second to the last flat we added, and that's the new key, if it's major. That's really all there is to that one. So in this case, adding that extra E flat now makes it a B flat key. So check it out. Wow, that was a lot. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to write a comment. If you want to keep learning about music theory or composition, be sure to like, share, and subscribe. But above all, have fun learning.